Hello friends, this is Shitanshu from Dream Abroad. Today, I've got two of my friends here with me who actually immigrated to Canada recently. So I thought of making this video so that you can know their experiences. So let me introduce to you. This is Kishore and this is Ashish. So the first question, why did you guys immigrate to Canada?
So I immigrated to Canada because Canada and Australia were two countries where immigration is possible, first of all. And secondly, this is, for a better living and money, saving more money. These are the only two primary reasons for which I migrated to Canada.
Okay, Ashish, what about you?
Okay, so my reasons were a bit on the personal side. So my wife, now she is my wife. Earlier she used to be my girlfriend. So she moved here to Canada. And I wanted to be with her, and that's why so country was fixed for me. But since it is easier to move to Canada because of its PR regulations and all, I chose to move here. And yeah, it was a good experience moving in here.
All right. So how were your initial days here? So you landed in the month of September, October last year. So how was your initial days and initial experiences?
So initial experience was like more like a kind of excitement. So I was here in a new country, in our dream country. So this is what I wanted. So this was more like an excitement. And then the settling part of the initial days, that was kind of easy because first of all, we were lucky to have a job when we landed here. So our employer had a branch here, so we came here. So we had a job, so we were on the lucky side. But other than that, the settling was comparatively very easy because Service Ontario and Service Canada is really helpful in helping people, especially the new immigrants. So settling would be really easy, actually.
What about you, Ashish?
So my experience was similar because even I had the job. And once you have a job, it is easy to get settled in. And I would say that the major part of it is that how you get a home. And that's where, you know, your contacts help, you know, before you land here, you try to contact people and see in which area, whatever you want to take the. So if you have a job, then it becomes easy because then you need a home near to your office, right? But if you don't have a job, in that case, you try to find a house where there's a more possibility of having a job. You know, that's where it's easier to go to your interview. So that should be your initial criteria when you land here. And after that, so there are two parts of it. One, if suppose you have been to other countries, other Western countries, suppose Europe and somewhere, then you almost know the culture. It's not very different from other Western countries. So it becomes easy to, you know their culture, the way the country operates. But if it is your first time, then better you adapt to their culture first, understand how they operate, understand how Western countries operate in that sense. So it makes your process easy to, in initial days. And once you get used to it, then life becomes easy.
Okay. So what were the difficulties that you faced in the initial days and maybe this time even?
So the difficulties primarily would be, of course, the climate part we have all discussed. So the climate part is definitely difficult because we all came in the winter time. So it was difficult for us to cope up. And apart from that, Ashish already mentioned, searching for a house is the most toughest and the most trickiest decision because you have to choose a place. If you have kids, you need to choose a place where there are good schools. Not all schools are good for all kinds of students, right? So we need to choose a place where the kids would be suitable. Or if you are like a bachelor or you want to place yourselves in a place where you can get a new job easily. So searching for a house was the toughest part. And apart from that, I would say the public transport is not so well connected in all regions. Like, it's very good within Toronto and all those things, but if you're going outside Toronto, as far as you get, the public transport gets, the intervals between the buses are really long. So that would be really tough. So you need to have a car to survive, actually.
So, yeah, so I would say similar to what he just said, means battle that you fight here is that you need to do everything yourself. You know, life in India is easy in some sense. People think, okay, we go to Western countries and life become easy. It does in some sense that, okay, your services, like in terms of, you know, the government services become faster and, you know, you don't have to queue up and all this. But the difficulty that you get is in your daily lives. You don't get servants here. You don't get a maid here to get clean your house. You don't get a cook here to cook, you know, for yourself, or you don't get a driver here very easily, or you don't have an auto here to go somewhere. You need to rely on Uber only.
Right, so this was a point which I mentioned in another video, that why Canada might not be the right place for you. Of course, the other very important point is the weather. So what are your comments on the weather? Yeah. So we have, let me tell you before this anything, we actually arrived last year, just before the winters was about to start. So we had experienced the winters, and the last winter was pretty horrible. So
and that winter, just to mention, that winter was the worst winter, the worst second worst winter in the last 100 years of Canada. There were a month where the temperature didn't go above minus 25. The whole January the temperature was not above minus 25, and those and people who have not been in this condition, they cannot imagine what is minus 25 feels like, you know, because you have never been in such temperatures. So you can't imagine what it is to be like here. But once you do here, then you realize that if you are taking your hand out, you can literally see your hand, the snow getting on your hand. Okay, and it feels like if you do this, your finger will go out. You know, so it is difficult to imagine. So prepare yourself for worst once you land for a winter, which is harshest winter.
So obviously, having said that, they have got enough resources for that. Obviously, you have to wear the snow boots, snow jackets. They are all meant to be to survive, you know, for like you can obviously survive in that weather with those jackets and with those boots. So yeah, weather is definitely, I would say, is the most difficult part.
But on the hindsight, once we know that we are going to settle here, what I learned from Canadians is that we need to start enjoying the winter. The way we can enjoy the winter is through winter sports, like for example skiing, because I have never done skiing in my life, but I had to learn it because so that at least some weekend, because in weekend you cannot plan anything else apart from skiing, or you can have a dinner at your friend's place. But apart from these two activities, nothing can be done. You cannot go to a park or you cannot do anything. So we must try to enjoy the winter along with the activities. Otherwise, your winter would be a very depressing time to be here. So try to enjoy the winter along with some activities or plan something with your friends. That would be the best way to handle it.
Okay. So another question I want to ask you that, about the homesickness. Okay, obviously Canada is pretty far from here, so from your home country. So what about the homesickness? What do you do to, you know, cope up with that?
So of course, you cannot leave away the fact that you will be homesick and you will miss India, that is for sure. I mean, I am from India, so I will miss my home country. But there are other ways to cope up with that, because there are many Indians here. So there are some places where you feel really like home, like there are temples here, there are churches here, so there are mosques. So I mean, and if you have your own community people, like if you are from North Indian, there are many North Indian communities here, there are South Indian communities are there. So, and restaurants, movies. So you get connected to India in some way or other, so you won't miss India as much as you expected. So this was kind of easy to handle when you meet people from your own country. So, and you eat their food, then things will be like a bit more easier.
So yeah, this thing I've also experienced, you know, that probably you the food is very, very important factor. I miss a lot of Indian food, but luckily we've got many Indian restaurants here, and everything is so good that, you know, we don't actually tend to miss that much. But definitely you'll miss your home country.
Hello friends, so hope you found our experiences useful. So in case of any more queries, like,
comment and subscribe the channel Dream Abroad.